Hello students, today we continue our chapter number 11 in exercise 11.1. In previous video we complete our question number 3, now we start with question number 4. The same thing in previous exercise question number 3, in that there is a triangles which is 30, 15 and 22 multiplied by 2, it means all are acute angle. Now here first one is acute and then after two is obtuse angle we have to draw. Okay, so let's start with the question number 4. In that first one is 75 degree. Okay, so before you have to what to think about that it's the angle, the given angle is in between which angle. So we have the graph, we have the common things. We easily draw the 0, 60, 120 and 180. In between 60 and 120 there is 90. Okay, then now we know that 75 is in between 60 and 90. So before we draw the 75 we need an angle 60 and 90. Okay, so I don't write that the points of 60 and 90. Okay, you know that how to draw angle 60 and 90 because you already drawn in previous exercise. Okay, or previous questions. So let's start with the 75. How to draw 75? So we know that already I told you, you have to first draw 60 degree angle. How you draw the 60 degree angle? Let's recall that. First, that is 60. It is 90. Okay, it is 75. So for before we start the draw the construction of angle 60, so you have what to do? You have to first draw a ray BC. Then after articulate arbitrary radius and make a semicircle. Then same radius on D, that is a round curve, and take 1 arc for E to F. So this angle is known as 60 degree angle. Now for 90, GBC is 90. For that, take arc on E and same radius offside, and from there you have to take a arc and connect. So you get the 90 degree angle. Now let, okay, till we draw 90 degree. Now take on DG ray, that is a point which is intersect on semicircle taking F. Let ray BG intersect the arc of circle at H. So we give it to H. Now the same thing you perform in previous terms. Okay, the same thing here we perform. Okay, so HE taking E as a center and radius greater than 1 by HE. So you have to measure this HE taking the E as a center in 1 arc. Same edge as a center, the same radius you take from step number 4 and R, this side, and which is intersect, given name is R. Now with edge as a center, radius greater than 1 by H, draw another R, cutting the R drawn in step number 4 at R. So that is R. Now join D and I and draw ray BC. So you get JBC, this one is 75 degree angle. Okay, let's check with the protractor. In your question that is clearly mentioned using the protractor, you have to check. So we check it. Yes, it is 75. Yes, the perfect one, 75. Okay, like this you have to draw it. Okay, note down all the points and construction. Once again I told you students, you have to first what you draw, you have to write continuously. Okay, if you draw a ray, then you have to write draw a ray AB is equal to whatever. You take any measurement. Okay, right. Next one is 105 degree. Okay, so for that we know that we have basic angle, that is 60 and 120. Right now, still here, before first one is all our acute angle. So we take a base as a 60 degree. Using 60 degree we are doing. Now for optics angle, so we take 120 degree angle. Okay? So you know that how to draw 120. We go for 60 and then take arc. This is for 120 degree. Okay? So it is for 120 degree. So using the 120, 60 and 120, we get 90 degree. Now 90 and 120, in between there is 105. So similar like a 75 degree angle. Okay? So that is 75 is in between 60 and 90. Similar, that is in between 90 and 120. So same thing. Okay, just the side change because it is obtuse angle. So it's go for left side. Okay, let's start. So angle ABC. Here we draw angle ABC, that is for 60. Now the angle ABC, that is 120 degree. Angle GBC, that is 90 degree. Okay, so let the negative the point on the arc, that is H. Let way BG intersect the arc at circle at H. Now taking H or F as a center and radius is 1 by 2 HF. Okay, 1 by 2 HF and take on R. Now H as a center, same radius, take arc on that, you get the intersection point is taking R. Simple, with F as a center and radius greater than 1 by 2 HF. Join R. Similar, H as a center, radius greater than 1 by 2 HF. Draw another arc, cutting the arc drawn in step number 4, that is I. Now join B and I, B and I, and draw ray B shape. So angle J, B, C, that is 105 degree. Okay, let's check with the product term. Okay, let's check, that is 100, 110. In between there is 105. Get it? Okay. Now the next one, third one of this question, there is 135 degree. Okay, students. So you have what to do? You have go for 135. There is 180. There is 120. In between there is a 150. So my key is here. That is 150. Now 150 and 120. In there is 135 is here. You have to write yourself. That is for mama. Okay. Again, repeat for you. There is 120, 180. In between here, 150. And in between 150 and 120, you get 135. Solve yourself. Okay. This was this construction. Draw and note down the points. Then after you have to try for 135. Okay. Do it. Construction number 5. Construct an equilateral triangle given its sides. Okay. First of all, what is equilateral triangle? It means that as all sides are equal, then it is known as equilateral triangle. Okay. So now let's start. First of all, first side we have to just assume. Okay. I think this we take a base BC. We assume it. Draw a right segment BC of length. Blank centimeter. Here I take blank. Why? Because if you want to take 8 cm, 10 cm, 6 cm, it's totally depend on you. Okay? Here there is a big scale, so I take at least here 40 cm. Okay? You don't want to take 40 cm. Okay? Clear? That's why I just here taking blank. Okay? Again I erase it. Now, here what to do? We know that the equilateral triangle, if the triangle is equilateral, then its angle is always 60 degree. So, I just draw the 60 degree angle at point B. Semicircle, taking here from one arc and take a ray, that is M. So, M, B, C, that is 60 degree angle. At D, draw at the end AC is equal to 60 degree angle. Okay. Now we have what to do. Here to path, we have to draw one perpendicular line. What is the perpendicular means? It make a 90 degree angle. So draw a perpendicular bisector. How you draw? Taking E as a center. What to do here? Here make more than half arc and upside arc similar downside arc. Now C as a center, upside arc similar, here downside arc as a C as a center, and intersection point is E and Q and draw a line segment. Okay, clear? Now let A and B, okay, here angle MBC, in that there is a line intersect, which is intersection point is A, and from for BC that is point D. B the points where BQ intersect is the row ray BM and side BC respectively. At ray BM, if we go further and intersect A, downside that is point D on line segment BC. Now join AC. Thus, join AC. If we draw, it gets our AABC is the required equilateral triangle. Okay, how to draw equilateral triangle? So, first step, we have to draw one line segment. It's depend on you. Then, after draw a 60 degree angle, then take a perpendicular. How to draw perpendicular? D as a center, upside arc and downside. C as a center. Upside and downside arc and connect. Intersection point given name and join AC. So you get your equilateral triangle. Here our chapter number 11 finished. I hope, and make sure if you want to prepare this construction, you have to draw at least 2 or 3 times in your rough book. If you get more and more practice, you can solve easily any angle. Okay, given so many. Any of angles, so you can draw the construction. Okay, note it down.